choirs of angels sing in exultation. Sing, all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, all glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet thee on this happy morning. Jesus, to thee be all glory give.
So good that we're all here today to celebrate this solemnity, the solemnity of the birth of our Savior. And as we do so, let us begin our prayer in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And I welcome those on our live stream as well. Hi, Mom in Phoenix. Happy Merry Christmas. And to all those who are watching us via live stream or later on today on the posting of our Christmas Mass today, we thank you for your participation within our parish community here at St. Norbert's. And welcome to all those who might be visiting, in from town, back from school, those who have gathered with us today, that we gather our prayers all together as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
We bless you, we
Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created the dignity of human nature and still more wonderfully restored it, grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him who brings glad tidings, announcing peace, bearing good news, announcing salvation and saying to Zion, your God is king. Hark, your sentinels raise a cry, together they shout for joy, for they see directly before their eyes the Lord restoring Zion. Break out together in song, O ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord comforts his people. He redeems Jerusalem. The Lord has bared his holy arm in the sight of all the nations. All the ends of the earth will behold the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Trumpets and with horn, sing in your joy.
reading from the beginning of the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, in times past, God spoke in partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he has spoken to us through the Son, whom he made heir of all things, and through whom he created the universe, who is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and who sustains all things by his mighty word. When he had accomplished purification from sins, he took his seat at the right hand of the Majesty on high, as far superior to the angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be a father to him, and he will be a son to me"? And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all the angels of God worship him." The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came to be through him. Without him, nothing came to be. What came to be through him was life. And this life was the light of the human race. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him. But the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To those who believe in his name, who were born not by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by man's decision, but of God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. And we saw his glory, the glory as the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, saying, "This was of whom I said, 'The one who is coming after me ranks ahead of me, because he existed before me.' From the fullness we have all received grace in place of grace. Because while the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, the only Son, God, who is at the Father's side, has revealed him." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, Merry Christmas. We made it. Yay. What a great joy to celebrate today with you, to celebrate the joys of Christmas, the light that came into the world, as we hear in the gospel today of John. Christ is that light, and he has been born unto us. Christ born in a manger. You're probably going, where's our manger? I don't see it here. Well, if you go to the front doors of the church, you can look in there, and our manger's right there. So we didn't want to keep it outside because sheep have legs and can walk away. So we wanted to make sure our manger scene or creche was in a safe place during this time. So if you want to take a moment after receiving communion at the end of Mass to go and see our manger, that'd be a good place to say a few prayers. But we gather because of that journey that Joseph and Mary made, ended up in Bethlehem, and were born, Jesus born, in a place where I'm sure Mary and Joseph did not intend that to be the place. Their journey was rigorous, that's the word, and ended up no place in the inn, but ended up in a manger. I'm sure that journey was difficult. And I know this time in the season, during this time in our history is difficult. Yesterday we had beautiful masses. At 3 o'clock Mass it began to rain, but they had troopers out there. It rained and then it stopped. And right as I'm raising the Eucharist, the sun came out, and right in my eyes too. So after the sun came out, we were distributing communion at the end of Mass, and people were calling me, Father, you got to come over here. I know I have Jesus right here. And the wind started to kick up and pulled me over. Father, look. And right over here was a double rainbow. A beautiful double rainbow. Those things that we might just take for granted. Those things in the time of the season where we think everything is going crazy today. But the Lord is here. The Lord dwells among us. And in those difficult moments of life, God is here. God dwells among his people. He is that light that shines in darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome the light. That God dwells among us. What are we called to do during this Christmas? We are called to pray. We are called to give thanks to God for the blessings we have received. We're called to open presents. Called to share those gifts. To share our love for each other. I want to thank all those who helped in our adoptive family program this year. We have had countless numbers of gift cards come in for needy families in our community. And as of, I think it was yesterday, the day before, so we already had over $13,000 raised for needy families in our community and distributed to them. We have so many left over, so we're going to have gifts at Epiphany. But what a gift and a blessing to realize that others who are in need. And some of the comments were, thank you for this wonderful gift because I just lost my job. Have no food to put on the table. And this will provide for my family for weeks to come. Thank you for I wasn't able to give my children any gifts this year. So these wonderful comments that have come out. And maybe some of you are those needy families. Maybe there are some of you that gave generously to give to others who are in need. And that's the moment of the season as well. To recognize that we are called to give. That we're called to love. We're called to look at what is truly important in our lives. And maybe this pandemic time has made us stop a little bit to reevaluate, to put in priority what truly is of value to me. Family and faith and love of God. For God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son to dwell in the world and to be with us in all things but sin and to show us the way to everlasting life. So that is the joy that we celebrate today. The joy of the season. And after all the wind last night, and after all the... We did have all our masses yesterday. And as we're getting ready for the last mass at 8:30 last night, it was calm. It was perfect. And we had this wonderful quartet here last night. And it filled the night. And they're back today. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Lois, thank you as well. The great gift that we have and to celebrate the beauty of this day. So let us rejoice always in the knowledge that God is here and dwells among us. Let us now stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, men, and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, who was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Sorry, sister. The love of God is made manifest in Jesus, the Savior, who intercedes for us. Let us offer our prayers, trusting in the compassion of a loving God.
For the church, may all the faithful herald the good news of our Savior's birth by lives of gratitude, joy, and kindness towards others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of every nation, may the justice and mercy of God find its way into their hearts and bring peace to our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, especially those divided by hurt and misunderstanding, may the presence of the Christ child inspire reconciliation and bring healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and destitute, may those in need experience God's love incarnate through the generosity of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our homeless brothers and sisters, may the light of Christ guide them to shelter, warmth, and protection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people during this time of pandemic, may the celebration of Christmas fill the world with light in the midst of gloom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those among us who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, for those listed in the parish bulletin, and especially Megan Leonard, Debbie Gray, Anna Goodwin Davis, Rick Hennings, Maria Vasquez, Patricia Lara, Anne Maria Wen, Irene Pfeiffer, Gary Belz, Alan Miller, Carol Safarik, Peggy Schultz, Bishop Kevin Van, Roberto Calderon, Fanny Monroy. May God comfort them and restore them to health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Trinidad Limones, Rosita Evangelista, Hela Pesha, Morris Hoffman, Leo Moynier, Marcelo Reyna, Janet Alban. May they forever rejoice with their Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Robert Kim, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we have opened our hearts to you. Be attentive to the prayers we entrust to your mercy and grant us what we truly need. In the name of Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be pleasing and acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day, when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once again giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Kevin our Bishop, Timothy and Tan his brother bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. And let us now offer to each other a sign of peace.
Agnus Dei, qui solis peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, qui solis peccata mundi.
Peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi.
Peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Prior to my reception of communion today, I will pray with those on our live stream, those watching from home, a spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Sigh.
during this time of pandemic, here at St. Norbert, we have moved the reception of communion to the end of Mass. So those might be here for the first time, welcome. But we will be distributing communion at the end at the two locations on this side here and one over on this side over here. And you might receive communion, but still remain a moment of reverence after receiving the Lord. But go see the creche in the front. Just remember that we are still in that, even though it's moved the time, but it's still are the body, sacred body of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world born this day is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver even of immortality, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow down and pray for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illuminated this most holy day, drive far from you the darkness of vice, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue. Amen. May God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives and make you heralds of the gospel. Amen. And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor and make you sharers with the church in heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us now go forth in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah.